What was the process into getting to into mixed media, and also what kind of mixed media are you doing?
So, in the past, with some of my paintings getting more and more texturized, I wanted to add more expression, more depth, and just the paint alone, globbing paint on there by itself. I started learning how to use acrylic polymer medium and different types of hue, different types of levels, so semi, gloss, and matte. And I noticed that it had a really good finish to it. And sometimes it would be mistaken as an oil painting, and it's acrylic because of the way you finish it, even after varnishing. And then on top of that, if it wasn't the polymer mixture of the medium, acrylic medium, then it was the gesso that I would use as the texture and then paint over that. And that I fell in love with the look and the finish of it. And I decided, well, what else could we do to make it more expressive, more depth, more eye-catching, more pop, more emphasis in a certain area of the painting? And I looked at, I'm looking at the bucket right now. It's called ProForm. Professional formula, but it's a lightweight joint compound. Basically, it's drywall mud.
Okay, I was
And I've
just
been
going to say,
using.
what's joint compound? Because I know I don't know what it is. I'm sure other people probably do, but I know that you've done a few, and they even kind of look like sculptures. But it's also you've said that it's acrylic. I want to say that there's one where there's like a face shooting out of a canvas or something like that. And I'm like, is that really just acrylic, or like did you slop on the paint and make a sculpture out of it? Or so tell me more about using the joint compound.
So with the joint compound, and that's a really good example. I'm glad you brought that one up. That one's called Black as Gold. That one that was sold already. Just in case anyone's wondering, let me hear this piece later. But that was basically a canvas board, and then I used drywall mud and sculpted it using very fine, expensive tools such as a spoon, a baby butter knife, and my fingers.
Nice.
And once the drywall mud or the joint compound dried, then I went ahead and took a really soft sandpaper. I'm looking for the grade now. I don't have the grade in front of me, but it's not the really heavy, coarse sandpaper because that's not necessary. Because when drywall dries, it finally is set and cured. Then you can go in and it's pretty soft, and you want to go ahead and do that outdoors or have your mask on in a setting where there's an exhaust fan because of the dust. But just a really light sanding down to smooth the edges if you want to have a smoother look. And then once that's done, then I go ahead and apply the acrylic right onto the drywall as if you're painting over a wall itself. That's the one that I fell in love with, and I decided just to carry on forward with the next pieces. I had a smaller one. It's not as impressive, in my opinion, it's for myself, but it was experimental, so.